Hey guys, my name is That Quiet Kid, and today we are going to do week 9 assignment of NPTEL Ethical Hacking. So the first question is, why do packet sniffers require the network interface card, that is NIC, to be put in promiscuous mode so that all the packets across the NIC card can be read? Even though if they don't know the destination, they can still read the packet. That is why the NIC card is, you know, put in this promiscuous mode. So second is, which of the following measures can prevent packet sniffing on a network segment? So restrict physical access to the network by unauthorized persons. It is correct. Use encryption to protect confidential information like VPN. We can use VPN to protect our, you know, confidential information. So this is also correct. Install the latest version of TCP protocol that does not contain vulnerabilities. I think this is regarding IPv4 and IPv6. So I think IPv6 is more secure, so that's what this is about. So all of these is the correct answer. Moving on to question number 3, we have, how can Nmap detect whether network sniffing is probably going on a network? So by using a script that checks whether any of the machines has the network card configured in the promiscuous mode. So which of the following features are present in the EtherCAP? IP based and MAC based filtering is present. Corrector injection is basically sending some correctors with the request, and packet filtering and, you know, dropping is also a feature of EtherCAP. Basically, this SQL injection is, you can also do SQL injection using EtherCAP. I read an article regarding this, that a person used man in the middle with EtherCAP to, you know, modify the request sent to between a Microsoft SQL server and a client. So, but it is not a feature, but you can still do it. It is not a specified feature, but you can do it. Moving on to fifth question, we have, which of the following can be used for computer based social engineering attacks? So tailgating is basically you are using a fake badge, or, you know, fake badge or identification card, and you are trying to get in somewhere which you don't have any access to. So you are basically moving behind a person that has access to with your fake badges and credentials. Sending out chain letter emails. So basically, chain letter emails are the emails which show you that you have won this gift, etc., and an illegitimate email falsely claiming to be from a legitimate site. So this is also a computer-based social engineering attack. Reverse social engineering is not a computer-based social engineering attack, but it is a human-based social engineering attack. Basically, in reverse social engineering, what we do is we don't make the user think that we are trying to get any information from him, but we are basically saying that we are this authority, and, you know, making him give information by himself without him knowing it. Which of the following tools can be used to put the NIC network integrated card in promiscuous mode? So ARP spoof is a tool which we can use. Which of the following protocols are vulnerable to sniffing attacks? So to sniffing attack, HTTP, FTP, these two are vulnerable. This HTTPS and SSL are secure encrypted, so basically they are not vulnerable to sniffing attack. How does slow loris work? So it basically works by sending multiple HTTP requests to the victims, but it basically never completes the, you know, request. It makes it hold the request for a long time. So this is how slow loris attack works. It's basically a DDoS attack. Which of the following is our examples of bandwidth flood? So ICMP flood and sync flood. In basically sync flood, we send the request, and basically there is a limit, I think up to 75 seconds up to which a request is held, and you basically keep on sending requests and basically flood the network. So for mounting DOS attack using HPing3 tool, what option can be used as an alternative to IU10000? So basically this IU10000 means it's I is for interval and U10000 means wait for 10 seconds. So you can replace this using dash dash fast option, which means send 10 requests per per second, 10 requests per second, and this faster is for 100. So basically this fast is the alternate of using this U10000 it's 10,000 is in microseconds. So that completes our assignment, and thank you for watching.